know why? Because I started wiping my feet when I leave the house.
This is revenge, right?
What?
This is revenge for me working with Dylan.
Well, I don't trust him.
He helped me get this airline pitch.
Yeah, and it'll be big money, and then we'll live happily ever after.
Well, speaking of which, what's for dinner?
It's your turn.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Do a roast. Etty will need comfort food tonight. Did you see Rosie off okay?
Are you okay?
Yep. As soon as Rosie's finished all her studies, she's coming back to me.
How could you not tell Baxter?
He wanted me to look after Howie, not smack him over the head with a bottle.
No more than he deserves, if you ask me.
Are you also going to forget to mention that Howie charged you with assault?
Hi, Bex. Oh, tried to kill your charity case, and now I'm facing prison.
Well, that's Howie's fault, not yours. Why Baxter doesn't give up on the bludger, I can't imagine.
Baxter tries to live by the gospel and not just drone on about it.
There's a time to let people do what they will. People like Howie, anyway.
I'm supposed to feel compassion, but all I can think about is how much of a dick he is.
Yeah, well, that's not something I'd voice in court.
Yeah, maybe not.
Hey, tell him before someone else does.
You're giving a little talk at the conference next week.
Oh, a few war stories and a pie chart.
Mm-hmm. And I hear that TK got dragged in to do the grunt work for you.
His words or yours?
Mine. Brutal exploitation, I call it.
Well, I'll be working with him. We're going through some case files tonight.
No, we're going to the comedy club tonight.
No, I meant to say...
Don't. Your first priority is me.
I've only got a week to prepare for this conference.
Well, TK can handle it.
I thought you were on his side.
I'm on everybody's side. And I need to get some cash from you later.
For?
Well, I think TK deserves a little more than a pat on the back, don't you?
Oh, hey, you.
Hey. Want to see why your genius daughter just got top marks for her assignment?
Sure.
Many of us in Clean Green New Zealand are opposed to genetically modified food. But do we know what genetically modified really means?
You don't have to watch the whole thing.
No, I'm really impressed. Who made it?
Me?
No way. What, on your own?
What do you think I've been doing till 3 a.m. for the last fortnight?
Well, you did this on your laptop.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
Currently in New Zealand,
the Scarlet.
19 crops are grown commercially.
Uh-oh.
You're still on good terms with TK, right?
Yes.
Okay, I've just got a very, very small favour to ask of you.
Is Lizzie still on card 9?
Yum! Yeah, he's been playing nothing but reggae.
Great.
Can't help but feel sorry for him, though.
Why?
Well, he's about to learn that a long-distance romance is a slow train crash.
It might work.
Have you ever heard of a single case that did?
No.
Only it'll be okay if Rosie was gone, you know, a couple of months, but 2 years.
Yeah. You can't expect teenage hormones to stay in check.
Mm-hmm. I just hope his bubble doesn't burst too soon. He's got a nice roast chicken to keep him happy tonight.
Good thinking, missus. We can't be shared eating roast potatoes.
Guys, I'm just gonna go for a walk.
Oh, okay. Well, dinner's at 6:30.
Missing Rosie already, I think.
Oh, well. We'll feed him roast and we'll talk him around, eh?
Yeah. We know how to cheer him up.
Yeah.
Finally.
Hey, you've been through hell.
Well, I'm okay. I missed you, though.
Yeah, same.
Hey, we'll catch up later on and I'll apologize for leaving you with Howie.
Yeah, we really need to talk about that.
I'll make it up to you, babe. I'll get him set up for the night and then I'll take you out someplace nice.
That would be really great, but it's just that...
I owe it to you. You've looked after him without a complaint.
Yeah.
Hey, is he getting any better?
In a sense, he is. It's kind of complicated, though.
I'll see you later.
Hello, Shortland Street Hospital.
Hey. Hey. What's up?
You don't want to know.
Oh, of course I do. Hearing other people's problems always cheers me up. Shoot.
Okay. My girlfriend's gone to New York to some fancy music school where she'll meet thousands of really good-looking musicians and probably fall in love and forget all about me.
Right.
And then I'll get this email or whatever saying, it was great, Etty, but...
Well, it might not necessarily...
And then she'll get married to this dude and I'll be lucky if I ever meet anyone even half as good as her. Ever.
Got to hand it to you. Your love life makes mine look pretty dull at the moment. Lesbos, jet-setting musicians.
Must be great having you as a doctor. You've got cancer, but don't worry, your heart condition's gonna kill you first.
Okay, all right, so this girl, she's away for a while, yeah? Well, it's not the end of the world. It's not like you've sworn eternal love, forsaking all others. So how long is she away? A couple months?
A couple of years, maybe longer.
All right.
Have you ever had a long-distance girlfriend?
Oh, a few, yeah. Like this girl I met when I was working in Fiji. Yeah.
Didn't really work out, did it?
No.
Do you know anyone who's ever had a successful long-distance relationship? See you later, bro.
Oh, hold it, hang on. I know a guy. Yeah, his girl went to India, and when she came back, they got back together.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, hang on.
What?
Oh, I'm sorry. I think it was her sister we got back together with. Does your girl have a sister? Cousin, maybe?
Have you managed to see Claire yet?
Briefly. We'll catch up properly later on.
And did she say anything?
About? Excuse me.
Hello.
Hey, Phil. How's it going, mate? All right, then, I'll get down there as soon as I can. Cheers, see ya. Howie's down at the church, drunk and abusive. Do you think I might be able to get away 10 minutes early?
Baxter, tell your friends to kick him out. Howie's a no-hoper.
There's always hope. Always.
Look, you've done your best, and he's done nothing but cause trouble.
I have to get down there. He's asking for me.
Well, make sure you see Claire and talk to her before you see him, OK?
Yeah, I will.
Roast is nearly ready.
Hope you're hungry.
Cheesecake for dessert.
Sorry, guys, I just don't really feel like eating at the moment.
Don't be too disheartened about Rosie.
Yeah, she'll be back in your arms in no time.
No, she won't. Long distance never works. Everyone knows that. Come on, Howie. In you come, mate.
You're like the brother I never had, mate.
You've got heaps of brothers.
But I never had you. You know, I never had that brotherly connection.
Let's get some food and coffee into you, eh?
Yeah, there you go. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Tell me, what was all of that fuss about back at the church?
Oh, I wanted to see you, mate. I wanted to sit down and play some cards, have a drink. Not the drink, bad for me, but, you know, you could go right ahead.
Yeah, well, pity you couldn't remember that half a bottle ago.
But this is what happens when you go away, mate. And I've got no one else to remind me, no one to look after me, like...
You had Claire, didn't you?
She didn't tell you?
Tell me what?
Well, I messed up again, mate. I mean, I probably deserved a bit of a verbal, just not being bashed. Still, I'm back on my feet now, eh?
Sorry? Bashed?
You with the bottle, eh? I mean, no, like permanent damage, they reckon.
Claire did that to you?
Yeah, I'm all right, though, mate. And apart from my eyesight's a little bit hazy and the ringing in my ears makes it hard to sleep. That's why I got back on the booze.
What the hell is he doing here?
Claire, what did you do to him?